So now that we understand the data structures, let's put the data structures to work. Let's first look at what happens on a page fault. On a page fault, the node first converts the virtual address to a UID. And once it converts it to the UID, it goes to the page ownership directory. And as I mentioned, the page ownership directory is something that I can trust. It'll tell me, given this UID, I'll tell you who the owner of this page is. And you go to him because he has the GCD data structure for this. So Node A finds out the identity of the owner for this UID, and that happens to be Node B. So it sends the UID over to Node B. And Node B, because it is the owner for this UID, it looks up its GCD data structure and says, oh, the PFD that can translate this UID, which actually represents this virtual address, is actually contained in this particular node, node C. So that's the content of this data structure. Given a UID, what is the node ID that contains the PFD? Remember that PFD is the equivalent of a page table in a normal system, and therefore that's the node that I want to send this UID to so that we can do the translation for this virtual address. So node B sends the UID over to node C, and node C contains the PFD that has the mapping between the UID and the page frame number that is backed by this node for this UID, retrieves the page, it's a hit, sends it over to node A. Node A is happy. It can then map this virtual address into its internal structure, and the page fault service is complete, and it can resume the process that was blocked for this page fault. So you can see that potentially when a page fault happens, I can have three levels of network communication. Of course, the first lookup of the POD is local to my node because this POD data structure is replicated on every node. So from the UID, I can find the owner for this UID. But then I have to send a network message over to the node that contains the GCD for this UID. And then he'll then send it to the node that has this page so that that page can come back. Now, this network communication I'm willing to tolerate because it is equivalent to performing the role of what the disk would have done. And maybe it is much better than going to a disk in order to get the missing page. So this is happening only on a page fault. And since it is on a page fault, this network communication is okay. But this is an extra network communication. Fortunately, the common case is a page fault is servicing the request of a local process on node A, and so the page is a non-shared page. And if it is a non-shared page, most likely the UID space that corresponds to the missing page is also managed by this node. Or in other words, both the POD and the GCD corresponding to a particular UID is mostly on this node itself. And this is true for non-shared pages. And so A and B are exactly the same node, so there is no network communication to go from the POD to GCD to find out the PFD. So hopefully, the only network communication that happens on every page fault is a network communication to go to this node that is serving the role of a disk and get the page from him. That's okay to incur because it probably is much lesser than going to the disk in order to do the page access. So the page fault service for the common case is going to be pretty quick. So the important message I want you to get out of this is that even though these distributed data structures may make it look like you're going to have a lot of network communication, important thing to note is that it happens only when there is a page fault. And since most of the page faults, the common case is going to be non-shared pages, the data structure POD and GCD are probably co-resident on the same node. So even though I've shown two different nodes here, A and B may be exactly the same node. And so looking up the PFD that currently is backing this particular UID is going to be local to this node. And so we can directly go to the node that contains the PFD and make the page fault service pretty quick.